Hey, what's up, everybody? Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, to Florida Hood Blogs. Today's video is about a sweet, charming little town between Ocala and Gainesville called Micanopy. We're going to talk about the history of this beautiful little town and give you guys some good information so you can plan your next vacation. Even though you're going to see a lot of cool stuff on this video, trust me, I did not spoil the whole thing. There's still a lot of really cool, neat things to see in this town that I'm not going to show you on the video because I don't want to ruin it for you. I want you to experience the whole thing. When you go to Micanopy, which I hope is the right pronunciation, the Mic is like Miccosukee. Micanopy is a name from Native American language, and we think it means high chief. And the town, because it was in Indian territory, was named that way to acknowledge the Native Americans' right to own the actual land in which the town sat on. The Seminole Indians acknowledged the African as equal to them, therefore they encouraged intermarriage between Native Americans and African Americans, and a lot of them were escaped slaves. So in this area, the African American culture runs really deep, and a lot of people have a lot of respect both for the African culture and the Native American culture in respecting the rights of the land and also in respecting the equality of the African Americans, which is seen in culture as in movies. There's two movies that were filmed here. Two amazing movies at that. I don't like movies today. I think they're pure garbage. But the movie of Doc Hollywood and Cross Creek are two absolute movies. Now, these are not, I like these movies personally, but these are not guy type movies. They're more, women will like these movies more. So if you are a female, you will enjoy these two movies. I enjoy them because I like romantic comedies and I like history, and I just like movies that have that old time feel, kind of like a Western, like a modern Western. I like those types of movies. And not so much Doc Hollywood, which is romantic comedy, but Cross Creek definitely has those elements. And before you visit this town, I strongly recommend that you take the time to watch both Doc Hollywood and Cross Creek. And also, The Earling is probably another good recommendation. I did not watch The Earling. I think it's too much of a girly movie for me. But if you're into girly movies, you might want to watch that as well. So understand a little bit of the culture and history before you come out here to this town so you can take a deeper understanding of what you're looking at. Before visiting, there's also a song that I want you to hear. It's by JJ Gray and Mofro. It's called Lottaloosa. Now, this triangle, there's a little triangle here between Gainesville, Ocala, and the town of Hawthorne. In that triangle is where you want to explore. There's Citra, there's Island Grove, there's Micanopy, and there's rural roads that wind back and forth between Cross Creek. There's two large lakes. There's Lake Orange and Lake Lottaloosa. This is the type of place where the guy can rent a boat and go fishing while the wife looks at antique stores. I mean, this is really one of the few places where the wife and the husband can both have an awesome time and enjoy a trip. So there's a little bit of both for everybody. I went to the restaurant called The Earling, and I personally enjoyed eating there. But there's many restaurants in the area that are amazing. So it's an awesome little day trip for anybody in Florida. You will be charmed beyond your imagination. You'll probably want to spend some money on antiques if you're into antiques, so just make sure you bring a little extra money. And you'll definitely come to the understanding that the history of Florida is much deeper than what we think. The history of this area is so deep that it goes all the way back to the time of the Spanish conquistadors. From the name of the towns to some of the stuff you're going to see is going to date back to that period. So this is a rich history in this area, and every Floridian needs to visit this town and just understand how deep the history runs here. Micanopy was one of the first real towns in Florida. That means that the historic district has some really old buildings, and there are some houses that are very primitive, very Victorian looking. Some of the houses that I saw remind me, I used to live in Louisville, Kentucky, and we have Old Louisville, which is a Victorian neighborhood. And some of the houses you're going to see are going to have that old feeling that you would not expect to find in Florida. I strongly suggest that you work your way all the way down to Island Grove, which is an abandoned mostly area of Florida. It's called an island because there's water all the way around it in some sort or another. It's not really an island, and if you look on a map, it's all green because there's water and trees mixed in together. But if you look at it on a black and white map, it's going to show water, but it's not really water, it's all trees. So it's just an area where land and water kind of meet, and it's hard to tell where one starts and the other one ends. The roads along Island Grove are just littered with so many historical buildings. A lot of them have been left exactly the way they should have been left. Some of those buildings date back as far as the 1800s, and these buildings, the locals have done a really good job just leaving things the way they were originally. There is a winery. Now, I'm not a wine person, I don't like wine. This winery is really unique. Their flavors are different. Their concepts are different. It's a little bit fruitier, tastier. I don't know how to describe it, but I'm not a wine person. But if, even though I'm not a wine person, I really enjoy their wine. And they have a lot of different stuff, so check it out. And their wine can be found anywhere in that area, from Ocala to Gainesville to Brooksville. You'll find in that area that the locals really like the wine. And I don't like wine, and I like their wines. I like their pineapple one. It's just really good stuff. So make sure you check that out, and you're definitely gonna fall in love with the wine. Now, a lot of the locals will be very warm, and they'll tell you so much. Like when I went to Micanopy, immediately one of the locals approached me and told me, "Hey, this person over here was in the movie. This happened." Blah. I'm not gonna ruin it for you. I'm not, like I said, I don't want to take away that from you. But the locals did fill me in on a lot of history. I got to meet people that were in movies. And they'll fill you in and they'll tell you a lot of stuff. And again, I don't want to ruin the experience for you, but the locals are very warm. And if you have any questions, they will address them. They do depend heavily on tourism. The antique shops are on a whole lit different level. I don't think I've been anywhere else in Florida where there's so many antique shops that are so big and that have just good collections of antiques. So if you're into antiques, you're an American picker, you like the picking aspect, you like the history of antique stores, you probably won't even be able to get to all the antique stores in this town in a day trip. There's that much to soak in this area. Incredibly, this little town is literally like less than a minute from Interstate 75. So you could be on Interstate 75, get off Interstate 75, and boom, you're there. And that's incredible how many times I've driven past there and not known that this little town was right there next to the highway. There's an internal battle between Floridians, with the ones who call themselves real Floridians, locals, natives, and transplants that have been here so long that they're almost locals. It's a huge internal battle between Floridians because there are places like this that really do not need to change. Now there's places along the beach, Miami, Naples, these places are Orlando, Tampa, they're growing, they're expanding. But we as Floridians have to know where to draw the line. Everybody wants their town not to grow, not to develop, not to be filled with transplants. But there are some places that really need to be preserved. And this area, this little triangle between Ocala, Gainesville, and Hawthorne, is definitely one of those places that we would probably want to keep exactly the way it is forever, if possible. I think development is definitely a huge concern for everybody in Florida, especially those who love and appreciate these small little towns like this. I mean, Bonita Springs, Florida, we have a beautiful historic district. Matter of fact, it's better than the original. I mean, we have lost a few buildings like the dome we had here in Bonita, but they've paved the sidewalks with pavers, they've turned the street intersections into roundabouts, they've preserved and brought in historic buildings from other parts of the city. The historic district in Bonita Springs is amazing. Even like Fort Myers Beach and other towns in the area are starting to copy that model and use that model of Bonita Springs and how they're gonna do their historic districts. So that's all surrounded by development. I mean, the city of Bonita Springs has developed incredibly in all directions for miles, yet they were still able to preserve their downtown district. And the historic district in Bonita Springs has really found a balance between preserving and addressing the important thing, which is the architectural importance of these buildings, preserving it and integrating it into the cityscape, and also making it functional so that instead of the buildings sitting vacant, they're actually a little thriving little business of people coming in and through the doors. And the historic district in Bonita Springs has really found a balance between preserving and addressing the important thing, which is the architectural importance of these buildings, preserving it and integrating it into the cityscape, and also making it functional so that instead of the buildings sitting vacant, they're actually a little thriving little business of people coming in and through the doors. And the historic district in Bonita Springs has really found a balance between preserving and addressing the important thing, which is the architectural importance of these buildings, preserving it and integrating it into the cityscape, and also making it functional so that instead of the buildings sitting vacant, they're actually a little thriving little business of people coming in and through the doors.